replace your windshield, and recalibrate your advanced safety system. Stay safe with SafeLight. Schedule now.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace.
Depression or anxiety, now might be the time to talk to a licensed therapist. It's just as easy as joining a video call or texting with a friend, except it's with a licensed professional therapist trained to listen and offer support. Talkspace, therapy for all.
Monkeypox, it's being spread mostly through sex. So at least now when you show up to the doctor with monkeypox, the doctor can be like, my man.
The Daily Show with Trevor Noah. New tonight at 11 on Comedy Central and streaming next day on Paramount Plus.
This can get better, can it?
Yes, it can.
I think it makes some money, buddy.
Bar Rescue continues next on Paramount Network.
With you throughout the years, being rude, you're very sharp with the customers. You should not be a part of the new company. I need to let you go. I'm very sorry.
That's okay.
Okay.
You got to be kidding.
Can I get a bitch? But I was willing to put that branding behind me, but you know, it keeps coming up because of Paul.
Brandon, put Jen on or you're fired.
Put her on your damn self. You own the jukebox. It wasn't fair what you did to me, Paul.
Decided to give Brandon a chance to prove himself at Relaunch. So I'm as surprised as everyone else. But I've got a staff that's ready to go, so we're going to get to work. Well, Paul, this is a bar rescue first. Brandon is gone. So let's just pick up where we are. This bar is the historic landmark, first gay nightclub ever in Las Vegas. That's great. But at the end of the day, I had to come up with a brand that would work. You guys ready to see it?
We are.
All right, on the count of three, turn around. One. Instead, he fell into his old ways and disappeared. But I have a staff that's excited, and we're going to launch it anyway.
Welcome to 1950s Miami. It's too bad Paul can't be with us. But let's open this place, let's pack it, let's make ourselves proud in public form.
As much as I love Paul, I know he's a difficult person. He has this whole spiel of he's changing, he's going to be a positive person, but he's always stuck in his ways.
This is the look of an ultra that 50s sexy Miami feel, and it's a great retro, high-energy lounge environment. Look at this unbelievable furniture I got from LV Liquidators. And then I got quality upholstery to come reupholster all your old seats. Look at how beautiful those are now. When I got here,
drag show, drag your bar to a complete stop for 45 minutes. So we put in three performance platforms. The new approach of 2 to 3 minute energy bursts will never stop the bar. And it sounds great now, guys. I got four wall entertainment and newav.com to redo the entire sound system. Let me show you the service bar. In a club this size, every seat is worth $15,000 a year. I added 28 seats to this room. That's why I had to put this in. Because now we have the service quick. The server can grab the glass, ice it, line them up with a bartender who pours in the liquor, garnish them, get them on the trays, and get them out faster. Let's go see the main bar. I got precision plumbing in here to fix the entire plumbing system. I also got micro-sync here to reprogram the POS system. This is the look for SBLV, a butler look that fits that South Beach look. You like it, Olivia?
Yeah, I like it.
Larry, Kenneth, what do you think of the place?
Gorgeous.
I did beautiful. Absolutely. Beautiful. Can't wait to work that time for that. All right, let's go to it. We open in a minute.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to SBLB. Come on in and have a good time.
Fresh lemon juice.
Thank you so much.
It's fantastic.
Overall, I mean, I feel like I did really well. I think everybody liked it.
Justin, can I go change?
Great to be featured up on the platform, as well as hear those rings of the cash register going off. So I loved it.
Guys, so unfortunately we had to do it without Paul. It was a good night, wasn't it?
It was a good night. Very good.
You know, congratulations. You were part of these past 5 days. Congratulations. Yes, you too.
I don't know what happened with Paul, but I know what to do. So with him or without him, I know I can pull it off.
Due to Paul's disappearing act tonight, his staff was able to shine and really take control of his club. But only time will tell how this lounge does when Paul comes back.
Promotional consideration provided by Cintas, Micros, AAA Restaurant Bar Supply, and Gladstone Industries.
I've been drinking in this bar for 20 years and ain't never caught nothing. We like bacteria. We like our drink.
For over 30 years, John Tapper has traveled the country, saving hundreds of bars from failure and ruin. Now he's headed to Atlantic Beach, Florida, to attempt to save Cappanoni's. 2 years ago, King Goings inherited Cappanoni's, a dive bar in Atlantic Beach, Florida, from her father, Jerry.
I'm Kim Goings. I own Cappanoni's Lounge. Cappanoni's has been here for about 36 years.
Since it opened, Cappanoni's has kept the family afloat.
My mom relies on this business for her every day, you know, living. Without it, we have nothing.
But when Jerry's health took a turn for the worse, the family had to take a step back.
My father got sick with Alzheimer's and dementia. And then after he passed, I stepped in and took over his role. I'm sorry that he had to go through what he went through. And I hope to make him proud. I do. Every day I walked in here, I was reminded every single day that my dad is not here. And Liz, my manager, is the person who ran it while he was sick.
Working for Jerry was awesome. I miss him every day. He taught me a lot.
So how's the beer? Can you taste the alcohol in that?
And the business has been taking a slide for a very long time.
We haven't really been here and have her sitting notes here like this.
Because, you know, they say customers are always right, but sometimes they're not always right.
When Liz was running it, it was more of a party scene.
I think it's shop time.
Drinking behind the bar.
Cheers. It's good to work.
You can't tell me that you are
bartender and you're drunk, you're handing the money properly? You can't tell me that.
We do the special all-you-can-drink for the customers. It's kind of our way of telling them we appreciate them.
You can't have that. You can't make a profit if that's what's happening.
Kim, we don't really see her as much, and that's where the problem starts.
I think that if Kim was here more, things would run smoother. But she shouldn't have to do that. Do you know what I mean? Like, what do you have a manager for?
Without Jerry's steady hand on the tiller, Cappanoni's quickly began taking on water.
There's a book of tabs.
They got a lot of people. Welcome.
You don't have any money Tuesday or Wednesday and you want to drink. Well, that tab is there for you when you get paid.
Drink your beer.
If that person doesn't come in today, then he's going to go home. So you lose the money if you don't run a tab.
You need something? You want the baby. You want the baby.
Are you kidding me? Liz has a tab. Her husband has a tab. Up to $200. Even our staff, they work 4 or 5 nights a week and make cash. And they all have jobs. And they all have money.
As customers ran up tabs, outside events threatened to sink the bar. After Hurricane Irma struck Jacksonville last fall, homes were destroyed. People focused on rebuilding their lives and weren't able to go out and spend money, hurting local businesses.
We had to shut down and it hurt everybody. That killed us.
I would like to see this place get busy again, you know, especially for Jared. It bothers us, all of us, that, you know, we feel like we failed him.
This was his baby. I want to make him proud. I do. I really do.
Now, Kim is desperately trying to put the wind back in Cappanoni's sales.
My mom and I have put in approximately $50,000 of our own money to keep it going, but there's no money left. We are probably losing about $3,000 or so a month. We can barely pay the bills. We have a really bad month, but we won't be here.
Afraid of leaving her father's legacy adrift, Kim has agreed to pull back the doors, bust open the books, and make a call for help. To Bar Rescue.
This bar has been here for 39 years.
Wow.
And it's named Odie's after a gentleman by the name of Jerry Odie. Passed away several years ago. Left the bar to his daughter, Kim. Now it's struggling. Jerry Odie's wife is still alive, and she depends upon this place for retirement. Kim is not an experienced bar owner. We can't expect a lot from her. She is screwed if this bar goes down. Can you imagine closing your father's legacy?
Only the weight of that.
She's in a jam. We're just a few miles out of two big Navy bases here. 15,000 sailors, about 30,000 family members. All the civil service employees that work on the base. There's a big Navy town. We got a pretty good marketplace. So for recon tonight, I want to get two sailors. Two guys from the base. I'd love to have them go in there and see what the hell they think.
Cappanoni's is a 4,300-square-foot dive bar with a dance floor and pool tables flanking a main seating area. The bar has two stations with cash registers on an island in the middle and no kitchen.
Okay, so here come our sailors. Here we go. There's Liz. She was a manager working underneath Odie, but now that Odie's gone, I don't think this place is running quite as well as it used to when he's there.
Oh, yeah, I'm a regular.
There's Robin. She's a bartender. There's Tivy, another bartender. And there's Miami, bartender and doorman.
This is my Friday. Yay!
Yay! So you know why those people are there tonight? They got what I call a drink and drown night. $10 at the door, all you can drink, whatever you want.
What?
Could you imagine being so desperate that you would do all you can drink on a Saturday night? All right, let's see how long it takes them to get a drink here. It's like they're not even there.
They're invisible.
This is remarkable.
Cheers.
Cheers. What are these bartenders? They're drinking behind the bar. They're smoking behind the bar. They've probably been smoking behind that bar for 20 years.
Absolutely.
You know what this bar reminds me of a little bit? When we went to Fairways. Remember that beer you had?
Oh my gosh, man.
I think over. Holy.
Dude, I think this might come up right now. I
right there, right all over the place.
So the bartender's drinking and not paying for drinks.
Krista says that she's going to maybe pay for tab tonight. Maybe?
What are they doing, Liz? Put it on the layaway plan?
Oh, come on. It's not that bad, really. Come on. That tab's going to be big.
Always do, Bob.
You know what?
She called.
Been almost 10 minutes. We haven't even been greeted or asked for any longer. What is up with this? They still don't have a drink. Don't you find this remarkable?
So
you know what this is? They take care of their friends.
But that old money is going to stay there. They're not going anywhere.
Yep.
That new money is what we should be attacking right there.
Hey, ma'am?
Yeah.
Can we get a drink?
Sure.
They stay there for like 10 minutes.
I'm sorry.
Whiskey sour?
A whiskey sour?
Whiskey sour meat. No ice.
Okay.
All right, whiskey sour is an easy drink.
Yeah.
Two ingredients, correct? Let's see what she's doing here. Okay, so there's whiskey and sour. You see one straight up there, Phil, without ice?
No.
Now, shouldn't a sour be shaken every time?
Yeah, you have citrus in there. You need to shake that. You need to bind the ingredients together. He's just straining it out. And add more sour. Good.
Oh!
That way you can't taste the whiskey whatsoever.
I have to go back and do it. Oopsie. There we go.
When somebody asks for no ice, it doesn't mean fill it up with more mix. It just means they don't want any ice in it.
Right. They understand that the drink won't necessarily fill the glass.
Sure.
Look on this face.
We'll get this, yes.
In the bathroom, it had something black in it.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
There's something floating in there.
They need to figure out what is floating in there, where it's coming from.
She said there was something floating in her Sprite.
They're just going to make another one and just pretend that it didn't happen?
Oh. What the hell is that?
So there's two drinks, there's something floating. Now, one was a soft drink from the gun.
Yeah.
This is not from the gun at all.
No. If something's in a soda and his drink, it's probably coming from where they scoop the ice from.
So it could contaminate everything. Let's go in and find it.
Been doing it for so long.
Have you taken checks from your mom to pay the bills here?
Sure.
You took the checks, we didn't change anything.
Right.
So you're guilty too.
I'm gonna be honest with you, I have emotionally checked out. I feel like I'm failing my father. And it tears me apart.
Have you heard about specks that are in all the drinks? There's something in these drinks here, some dirt or something that's going on behind the bar. Let's go to the bar.